I think there's a lot of great parts of this job, but absolutely the best part of this job is the first post-op visit after somebody's had surgery and they're coming back and they're, you know, maybe they weren't able to walk or they had to walk in a wheelchair or something before they came to see you. You fixed them and now they're walking, they're in no pain. They are so thankful, and that, you know, every time I have that experience, I just want to do it 1,000 times over.
My husband drove me to the emergency room here, and so then I came in, and they got me back to a emergency room as quickly as possible, and came in and started talking to me, and I think they knew immediately what they were dealing with, even though I didn't. Obviously I knew it was something to do with back, but really didn't have any idea what. And they're like, well, this sounds like a disc problem, and so we're gonna immediately try to get you in to start doing some tests.
The spinal team encompasses everybody from the very beginning in the clinic. So it's the assistants in the clinic who, you know, see this day in and day out. They recognize these patterns. They can easily categorize patients into, oh, this is a pinched nerve type, you know, problem. And we can already, at that point, before they've even had an MRI or any kind of treatment, start treatment.
And so I'm like, yep, this is definitely the worst pain I've ever felt in my life. And so then Dr. McElroy came in with his big smiling face and he's like, oh, I'm gonna get you taken care of.
And every once in a while, it's pretty common, but every once in a while, part of this disc will go into a place where it's not supposed to go. And there's not a lot of room in the spinal canal where this disc can go. And so if it goes there, a lot of times it starts irritating nerves, and you get weakness, you get pain, you get numbness, you can have a whole host of symptoms.
The disc between my L5 and S1 had ruptured and had gone down into the nerves. And so that was nerve pain that I was feeling. And I said it was worse than childbirth and it was worse than kidney stone, and I had done both.
In that case, the only real treatment is to remove that part of the disc, okay? Involves an incision, something like this, where we go in, we use a microscope, and we pluck out the disc. The remainder of the disc is in between the bone, we leave. You know, it's a cushion between the bone, it's still doing something, but we take the part that's crushing and strangling that nerve and causing all this pain, and we pull it out. It's a relatively, you know, quick and easy to recover from procedure. It takes maybe an hour, maybe 45 minutes to do. Outpatient, you go home the same day. And, you know, I've seen very good results from that.
Dr. McElroy went in and actually repaired the discs, went and cleaned out the damaged part and left the good part alone, so I still had a little cushion in there. And immediately afterwards, I immediately was feeling a lot better. And so that was a huge relief. And I took a week off of work, and then I'm back at school doing my same old, same old. So, I mean, it was a pretty quick recovery, and everything went really, really smoothly.
Here at Presbyterian Flower Mound, you know, we use a lot of the newest technology, the least invasive type procedures, and so patients recover quite a bit faster from that kind of stuff compared to even just 10, 15 years ago. I mean, you're talking larger incisions, multiple nights, multiple days in the hospital, you know, weeks, months of recovery, and now it's much less than that. And so I think, you know, these, both the equipment we have in the operating room, but also all the surrounding support staff, the physical therapist, the occupational therapist, I mean, that makes a huge difference.